Hi, in this video I'll be discussing Xu and co-author's paper Show, Attend and Tell Neural Image Caption Generation with Visual Attention. In the field of image caption generation, this is a very significant and influential paper. This paper created captions using the attention method, and it was considered state-of-the-art at the time of publication. In this video, first, I go over some of the previous methods to generate image captions. Then I go over the specifics of the model used in this paper. We'll look at the hard and soft attention mechanisms in more detail. Finally, I will present the paper's results and conclusions. Chapter 1, Introduction. The problem of producing a description based on the input image is known as image captioning. Automatically, creating captions for an image is a challenge at the core of scene perception, which is one of computer vision's main objectives. Not only must caption generation models be capable of overcoming the computer vision challenges of deciding what objects are present in an image, but they must also be capable of capturing and expressing the relationships in natural language. Researchers tested several methods for image captioning before using neural networks to generate captions. For instance, using caption templates which were filled in based on the results of object detections and attribute discovery. Following the popularity of encoder-decoder models of machine translation, computer vision experts began using them to create image captions. But most of them used object detectors as an assistant in the image captioning problem. The current paper, on the other hand, does not explicitly use object detectors, but instead learns latent alignments from scratch. This allows the model to go beyond objectness and learn to attend to abstract concepts. Chapter 2, Model Details. This figure shows the architecture used in this paper. The model takes a raw image as its input. The picture is then processed using a convolutional neural network through three features. In an encoder-decoder model, this CNN acts as an encoder. Let's look at it in greater depth. The CNN used in this paper is using the VGG architecture, which is shown in this slide. This architecture processes an image through sequential convolutional layers followed by max pooling, and finally outputs a vector that captures the meaning of the image. In order to obtain a correspondence between the feature vectors and the portions of the 2D image, the authors extract features from a lower convolutional layer instead of using a fully connected layer. They take a 14 by 14 by 512 feature map. And by flattening each one of the 14 by 14 matrices in the feature map, we turn them into a set of vectors which we refer to as annotation vectors. The extractor produces L vectors, each of which is a D-dimensional representation corresponding to a part of the image. By concatenating these annotation vectors, we generate matrix A, which is the output of the CNN encoder, which is then used by the attention model to determine which sections of the image are more relevant in generating the next word in the image caption generation task. We'll go into the attention mechanism used in this paper in more detail in the next chapter. For now, let's take a look at the decoder, which is a RNN using the LSTM architecture. Here is the LSTM architecture used in the paper. If this figure looks scary to you, I recommend you take a look at Tor Data Science's great article, Illustrated Guide to LSTMs and GRUs, a step-by-step explanation, link to which is available in the description. The inputs of this LSTM model are the previously generated word YT, which is multiplied by an embedding matrix E, previous decoder hidden state HT-1, and the context vector ZT, which is a dynamic representation of the relevant part of the image input at time t. But how is this context vector calculated? At each time t and location I in the image, we can calculate an energy score. For each location I, the mechanism generates a positive weight alpha I, which can be interpreted either as the probability that location I is the right place to focus for producing the next word, or as the relative importance to give to location I in blending the annotation vectors together. Simply put, this model uses a multilayer perceptron to calculate energy scores, followed by a softmax layer to produce the attention weights. Once the weights, which sum to 1, are computed, the context vector ZT is computed by this function, where phi is a function that returns a single vector given the set of annotation vectors and their corresponding weights. Now we shall discuss the details of the phi function in the next chapter. Chapter 3, Hard and Soft Attention. As I previously said, this paper employs two separate methods for applying attention. Soft attention is one of them, in which the attention demonstrates the relative importance of each part of the image to the other parts. The other is hard attention, in which the attention separates certain parts of the image and we only consider these isolated parts when producing the next word in the caption generation task, while ignoring the rest. In both methods, we first calculate a weight for each annotation vector. The difference between soft and hard attention is the way we interpret these weights. In soft attention, we may simply assign higher values to the parts of the picture that have higher attention weights. As a result, the context vector would include the data from the annotation vector as well as the relative importance based on the attention weights. Here is the mathematical equation which can achieve what we are looking for in soft attention. In hard attention, instead of a weighted average, we use attention weights as a sample rate to pick one annotation vector as the input to the LSTM. As a result, only the most relevant aspects of the image are used in the context vector, and the remainder is ignored. Under the hood, hard attention is based on a complicated math formula. The spatial location of interest, coded as 0 or 1, can be parameterized by multinully or categorical distribution, and optimized using the log likelihood, intuitively representing the probability of seeing a sequence of words given a portion of the image. To calculate the gradient descent correctly in the backpropagation, we perform samplings and average our results using the Monte Carlo method. Optimization is achieved via a learning rule similar to reinforce. As you can see here, for some images, both hard and soft attention produce the same captions, but with different attention areas. Chapter 4, Results. Here is the results table as reported in the paper. The authors have tested their model on 3 datasets. Flickr 8K dataset consists of 8,000 images that are each paired with 5 different captions, which include detailed descriptions of the important individuals and events. The Flickr 30K dataset contains 31,000 images collected from Flickr, together with 5 reference sentences provided by human annotators. And Microsoft Coco Captions dataset contains over 1.5 million captions describing over 330,000 images. For the training and validation images, 5 independent human generation captions are provided for each image. We can see that the attention-based model introduced in this paper performs better than previous models in each and every dataset, on both Blue Score and Meteor Score. Both soft and hard variants of the attention model were trained with a stochastic gradient descent using adaptive learning rates. In terms of optimization techniques, they used RMSProp for the Fulker 8K dataset and Adam for the Fulker 30K and COCO datasets. In addition to dropout, the only other regularization strategy they used was early stopping on blue score. As we can see in this figure, the model learns alignments that agree very strongly with human intuition. We can see some examples of caption generation errors on this slide. These visualizations can be used to get an understanding of why such errors were made. Conclusion. This paper introduces a modular encoder-decoder with a CNN as the encoder and a RNN as the decoder, as well as an attention mechanism. A new, hard approach to calculating the attention weight has been proposed, which essentially lowers the computational cost. The proposed model gives state-of-the-art performance on three benchmark datasets using the Blue and Meteor metric for image caption generation task. Also, using visualized attention weights, authors demonstrated that learned alignments match human intuition very well. Thanks for watching. I hope you find this video educational and informative. If you like this video, please subscribe to my channel. See you in the next video.